You're watching the free version of Silhouette Essentials. For projects and footage, head to borisfx.com for the premium download.
Here is another hard surface roto sequence. Let's cache it through. It's an aerial shot, a push-in on an icy landscape. It's time for the shot approach to determine the what and the how. The what to do is to rotoscope all these foreground ice formations and the mountain ranges in the background. It's actually a bit more complex with this mid-ground area here, and several of the mountain ridges are at different depths. But given the camera movement here, the goal is to use tracking as much as possible for a procedural approach, and it's a perfect candidate. So let's get started, and today we are now working in Silhouette version 2023, the latest release. I have my final project over here, but I'm going to make a new roto node for the class demo. So another way to bring in a roto node is to double-click it in the nodes window. If I double-click the roto node here, you can see it appears in my trees window, but it's attached to my source node because my source node was selected when I double-clicked the roto node. I can easily extract it by selecting the roto node. Click E, and now it's extracted, and we'll attach it to our source over here. I'm going to go back to the Nodes tab because I want to show you the Favorites tab in the Nodes window. So here we're in the Silhouette tab, but if we go over here to the Favorites tab, you can see I've gathered all of my favorite nodes. And to add a node to the Favorites tab, this is what you do. For example, we'll go back to the Silhouette tab here, and I'll select Output Multipart. Then I will click this star icon here, click Favorites, and now you can see that I have this node in my Favorites tab now. And next up, I'm going to add a note node for our task list for the shot. So we'll just select our note node here. We can drag it into the trees window, and we'll make our task list for the shot here. We'll just navigate over here. We'll go down to the note node parameters. I'm going to select a larger font. First, I'm going to put in our shot range. And what we need to do. And we're ready to go. I'm going to name the roto node roto class demo. And I'm going to start with these foreground objects first. I'm going to use the Silhouette Planar Tracker for this task. The Planar Tracker has both some similarities and some differences from the built-in Mocha Tracker and Silhouette. They both allow for tracking in various channels and pre-processing, but there are some other differences. So let's take a look right now. We go to the Tracker tab here, and we are selected on the Planar Tracker tab. So there's a few more parameters. For tracking features, one can select Auto, Corner, Edges, and Ridges. For the motion model, there are three selections: Perspective, Affine, and Translation. And here we have some boxes with different parameters, but I usually don't change those. And down below, we have valid tracks and reference frame, and I usually just look at the valid tracks. And of course, up here, we have the different channels, luminance, red, green, and blue. So I'm going to start on the frame where my object is largest in frame. I'm going to select this ice formation to track first, and we'll go all the way to the end, and we'll zoom in. And press the plus key so we can see this object really clearly. So I'm going to make a shape around the object to the area that I want to track. I'm going to press S for X-spline in this class, and I'll make a shape around my object. I'm making my shape around the features in this object that I think the Silhouette Planar Tracker can capture in the tracking process. But I'm going to look at this edge here, and I might not go all the way around this corner here, or down here if it starts to overlap other ice formations, because I don't want to track a background piece of ice. So I'm going to move that in, and I'm just going to kind of scrub through and see how much is visible. So it looks like I can just probably get this little top edge here. And we'll go scrub through one more time. And I think we're going to be okay. So down in the tracker tab, we'll just go back to that section right now. So now we get to look at all these different parameters here. And first I'm going to just set this contrast and pre-processing back to the default so we can start fresh. So you can see these little tracking markers here. These are the valid tracks. And you can see down here in this window, it says 210. So I'm going to just try different options here. For the motion model, perspective is the default. But in addition, there's also a fine, which also tracks translation, rotation, scale, and skew. And then translation, which just tracks the XY offset. So in this case, I'm going to select a fine because I want to track all of those things. And also in addition, in general, perspective is good for tracking larger shapes, a fine for medium shapes, and translation for small shapes with the Silhouette Planar Tracker. Okay, so we'll go back and we're going to start changing up some of these parameters here to see if we can get the highest number of valid tracks. So I'm going to just try different tracking features. We have auto, we have corners, we have edges, and we have ridges. So I'm still looking for a larger percentage of, or a larger number of valid tracks. I'm going to go back to auto and I'm going to switch the channel to the red channel. That's a little bit less green, a little bit more, and then blue. Okay, and let's try some other parameters here. Auto, we'll go for corners. It's getting a little bit higher. Edges, not high, ridges, and then we'll go back to corners that seemed to have the highest amount. And I'm going to try some pre-processing. I'm going to switch on the preview here. So we have 248 valid tracks. We'll click on preview, and I'm just going to up the contrast if we can get more detail. And now you can see that our valid tracks are 209. And we'll just go back and see if we can just edit that a little bit more. Okay, we didn't need that much contrast, 286. All right, so let's track with that. I'm going to turn off the preview and track. I like the Silhouette Planar Tracker for organic shapes that have some rigid definition that also change in scale. I feel like all these internal tracks are acting like subplanar trackers to give a fairly precise tracking result. Okay, let's see how well our track worked. We'll go up here to the stabilize icon and we will choose our tracking layer. And we'll play this through. So it looks pretty good. There might be a little shift towards the start of the shot, but let's drop in our shape. I'm going to turn off our tracking shape. First, I'll name it track, TRK, and green, and then we'll just turn off the visibility. I'll click S, the hotkey for X-spline. I'll zoom in, and we'll make our shape. I don't have to worry too much about these areas that are over other ice formations. I'm just looking to have this outer edge rotoed for my shot. You're probably wondering why I don't use my tracking shape as the object shape, and that's because if my tracking was not successful, then I would have spent a lot of time making a detailed shape. Okay, and then we'll just scrub through, and we are doing this in the stabilized view. It's a lot easier that way. And looks like we have to make some edits up here. I'll just select that and use the arrow key and move those points down. And same with this point. In fact, I can even try the brush reshape at this point. I'm holding down the Control Command key to make my brush smaller. And it looks a little distorted, and that's because we are looking at the shape in the stabilized view, but that's okay. We can still use this here. Sometimes it's easier to grab points with the brush reshape. Okay, it looks good. We're going to go out of the stabilized view to none, and we'll deselect the shape and play it through. Let's turn on the overlay, the alpha overlay, but we'll turn off the outline and see how it looks. Okay, that looks pretty good. Okay, we'll turn the overlays off and our shape back on. And next we'll move on to one of the mountain ridges.